I'd like to have across the board expose as to what is going on in the field of parasite remedies, including ours, of course. Our contact information is here, our center. The two gentlemen at the bottom, we managed to train people from overseas when they need some training. The gentleman to the left was the head of our laboratory in Mali, in Timbuktu. And the gentleman to the right, who's from Quito, he's come to train in parasitology also with us in Arizona. Why we need to test, if any practitioner sees patients with any one or more of those tests, it calls for the question as to whether the patient needs some parasite testing, because as you perhaps have found out from your personal experience, doctors need to learn how to recognize parasite symptoms and need to consider parasitology as a possible cause for their symptoms, and not treating them with just steroids or whatever else they treat them with without putting that into account. It's very important to recognize those factors. The possible modes of action of parasites in en route of infection of the human body. And as far as bacterial infections go, the last one, the soil, becomes a very important factor. Our laboratory procedures, our methodology for processing parasitology specimens, process from collection to filtration to staining to centrifugation, and then putting the specimens on wet mounts which are examined microscopically. We've done ELISA, we've done all kinds of complement fixation, we've done tissue culture neutralization tests, we've done all kinds of tests for parasite recognition. And the one thing which I trust the most is visually being able to see it. If it's there, you will see it. If it is there, if it is not there, then you're not going to find it, irrespective of what test it is. I do not want to be too critical with other tests which are available in the market, but many of them have a very high margin of error, which makes them rejectable as far as our laboratory procedures go. Lists of parasites that we normally diagnose, and there's many other parasite species depending on where the patient has been in the world that we add at the end. Those are commonly acquired parasites in North America, but there's many other foreign parasites that we also diagnose and we annotate at the bottom under the remarks section. Roughly, one-third of the U.S. population has parasites. We also do bacteriology tests, and quite often we come across a patient that has typical GI tract infections, and our parasitology test shows that they have no parasites, and the question comes up, did we fail to find the parasite? Are we a good lab? How come the patient has clear-cut symptoms of GI tract infections or whatever related symptoms are, but we cannot find any parasites? When we do the same patient concurrently, the bacteriological swab culture test, looking for pathogenic bacteria, invariably the patient that has GI tract infection or related systemic infections with no parasites has a bacteria infection. And that becomes the ultimate cause for the symptomology rather than the parasite. So now we recommend, we have what we call a GI PEC test, where we recommend the patients gets tested for two things at the same time, for parasites and for bacteria at the same time. Those are the GI tract parasites that we find from swabs of fecal specimens, fresh fecal specimens, and swabs of the skin will produce these and more parasites that are annotated. If they are not on the list, they're annotated in the remarks below as to what else is there going on that is not on our magic list. Sensitivity test results and resistance test results. Our video for med schools and other schools. And this is the parasite remedies which are available in the market in the United States today. Some of them are not available in the United States, actually, like praziquantel, you cannot get it in the States. You have to go to a pharmacy that will put it together for you. Same as with tinidazole. but most of the rest you can find here. And of the herbal remedies, ours is the most broad spectrum, which covers all of protozoan, worm, bacteria, and fungus parasites. It is the only one that is available in the country that covers all this broad spectrum arena of infections. We formulated this parasite cleanse based on the research that we have done that was published for the most part in Explore magazine, one article on ancient Egyptian medicine, which has a list of a large number of botanical herbal remedies that the Egyptians have used 5,000 years ago, as well as Chinese medicine. And it is actually three formulations: Freedom, Cleanse, and Restore. And philosophically, the remedy is designed to fulfill the following three functions. If you look at the bottom paragraph here, a good botanical remedy for restoration of optimum digestive health is one that accomplishes three things. Defends the body from parasitic infections, that is, kills the parasites. Two, cleanses the colon from toxins and promotes regularity. Three, supports the integrity of damaged tissue, that is, restores the damaged tissue back to their normal state of healthfulness. Freedom accomplishes the first function, kills the parasite. Cleanse accomplishes the second function, and restore accomplishes the third function. So it's along this philosophical concept that this design of formulas was put together. The ingredients are listed here for Freedom, Cleanse, and Restore. And many of the ingredients, especially in Freedom, you can only find in the literature of the Edwin Smith papyrus and the Sinuhe papyrus that I got from ancient Egyptian remedies. And you will not find them in any other herbal remedy available in the market today. The formula, it is also energetically, synergistically put together. You will not find any ingredients in any one of these compositions which conflicts with something else within the same capsule. And we do not distill or extract from the original, but actually if you open up the capsule and you smell it or sniff it or even taste it, you can taste the ingredients one at a time in it, because we use the actual botanical component without breaking it apart. Because we recognize that the active ingredients function best when they are present in their natural state with other ingredients which may be regarded as non-active ingredients. Explore publication was one of that was very hospitable for our publications on the subject. This is the first page of one of our articles on herbal remedies. Kareem and I put this article together, and this includes about 800 herbal remedies that were researched and looked at, and information was made available to provide a foundation for our remedy. This is an example of one of the pages of that publication, which shows the 800 remedies by Latin names alphabetically, and the number of publications and efficacies reported for each. As you can see here, the garlic, for instance, was reported so many times as it is effective against worms. The parasites were classified to different groups, and we've noted that, for instance, garlic is one, aloe vera is another one that shows good efficacy against worms, as indicated by the number of publications indicating their efficacy in the literature. In the ancient Egyptian medicine article, published about 10 years ago or so, 9 years ago, has a list of ancient Egyptian remedies that have been used a few thousand years ago and what they were used for. All these articles are also available on our website. If you get our website and click under publications, on the first page, you can download any one of these articles and many more of the about 200 articles that were published by us on our website. Freedom, Cleanse, and Restore. Most efficient and popular herbal remedy for persoasis in the United States. It has stuff in it that are not in any other material. It is broad spectrum. Treats intestinal tissue invading protozoans and helminth. Notice intestinal and tissue, not just limited to the GI tract. Helminth parasites, as well as pathogenic bacteria, fungi, and yeast, found worldwide. We work with about 2,500 doctors worldwide that refer their patients to the patient samples to us for testing. And our information here is based on patients from across the world, not just the United States. Acts by killing the parasite, cleansing the organ, restoring damaged tissue, available worldwide, and ingredients are synergistically combined with compatible energies. This is a very important part of putting this thing together. Here is some of the feedback that we get unsolicited by patients that have taken use the product. Please, if nothing else, just look at the blue words. In each case, there have been eradication of numerous varieties of parasitic organisms, such as roundworms, hookworms, and amoeba. I would recommend the formulas to others with confidence. Doctor, I don't know if you know Dr. Anthony Farrow and many other sources of testimonials. Someone liked how they smells. Marcy really liked the product. She used to sniff it before she takes it. Within short time, I began to feel better. A flu-like feeling that I had for a very long time was gone. I have more energy, and so on and so forth. My symptoms were severe burning in my intestines and bladder, chronic constipation, bloating, spleen enlargement, foggy thinking, blah, blah. I had stopped dreaming, bad breath, bad odors, heavy menstrual bleeding, a poor mental attitude and anxiety. That's her symptoms before she took the remedy. This patient, I had heard Dr. Amin from my naturopathic doctor. I thought he is an expert in this field. After taking the first dose, I passed some parasites that I had never seen before. His supplements gave me my life back. I tried the traditional parasitic drugs that you get prescribed from other your doctor, such as mebendazole and other antihelminthic, with no results. The herbs in this supplement wreaked havoc on the parasites. You can read for yourself if you like, just if you focus on the words which are the highlights in blue. We ordered the FCR and our symptoms began to lessen almost immediately. Finally able to sleep through the night. I like the statement. What the other products in the market out there couldn't do, yours did. Thank you for all the hard work and for any trials that I can imagine that you might have gone through to make this product and get it on the market. Eternally grateful. Okay, I'm grateful for also for the positive response. This is going to be a quick list of the parasites that we know our remedy has successfully treated. I'll just go through this list quickly. Blastocystis hominis, Cryptosporidium parvum, Cyclospora cayetanensis, Entamoeba histolytica, Entamoeba coli, Giardia lamblia, Balantidium, Ascaris, Anisakis, hookworm, Strongyloides, Trichinella spiralis, Entrobius pinworm infection, Trichuris trichura, Diphyllobacterium latum, Tinea solium and Tinea saginatus or Tinurhynchus saginatus, Echinococcus granulosis, Hymenolupus nana and Hymenolupus diminuta. They usually infect the grain beetles, and you get them through the route of contaminated cereal. The beetles infect the granaries, and rodents facilitate the infection. And then you, if the cereal is not properly processed, then you get it with your cereal. S. mansoni, schistosomiasis, normally in West Africa and Central Africa, but also have pockets of infection in Central America. Lives in the hepatic portal system, in the bloodstream. Fasciola hepatica, Fasciola gigantica, the liver flukes. Fasciolopsis buscae. And other pathogens successfully treated by Freedom Cleanse and Restore, which are not of parasitic nature but of bacteriological nature, include Salmonella, E. coli, Citrobacter, Klebsiella, Campylobacter, Clostridium, Proteus, Shigella, and Yersinia pestis. Short and sweet.